Hello students, how are you all? I hope you all are fine and healthy. So today again we are here for learning science. In science we learn about different type of things, different type of food, different type of animals and many other things. We learn about safety rules which we have to follow at our home, in school and many other places. We learn about air and water, which is the needed thing for living life. So we learn that we need air to breathe, we need water to drink, and we also learn the different uses of air and water. Then we learn about weather, that weather is changes every day. We learn about different types of the day, which are the hot days, cold days and rainy days and windy days. We learn about seasons, that we have five seasons and many other things. So in science we learn every day new things, right? So let's start our today's lecture. As you know, I am your science teacher Mubassira Miss from Mahdi School. So today we start fair book exercise of lesson number 14. Our lesson name is the sun, moon and star. So in this lesson we learn about sun and we learn everything about sun, moon and star. So today first we revise our lesson number 14, that what we learn in this lesson. Why we revise this lesson first? Because we start fair book exercise. So first we revise the lesson, then we write the exercise. So today we write hard words in fair book, right? So let's start our today's lecture with one beautiful picture. So here on your screen you can see the picture. What is the picture? That one person is pushing other person, and you can see the both person are same. So what is meaning of the picture? That the only person who can really make you move is you. And you can see the arrow. The arrow show you that it is the dream. So if you want to fulfill your dream, if you want to achieve your goal in life, so first thing you need is you need to push yourself, right? And you are the only one who can really make to move, right? So if you are standing somewhere and if you are not going and you are stand there, so it is depend on you that you have to move or you have to stop there, right? So with this beautiful picture, let's start our today's lecture. So in this lesson we learn about sun. So what we learn about sun? So when we learn about sun and moon, we learn that sun and moon are same, but the color of both thing are different. So in first appearance, when we see sun, it is looking like a ball, as well as the moon is also looking like ball. But the color of the sun and moon are different. We also learn that sun is in same shape and size when the moon changes every night, right? So here first picture you can see on your screen, it is the picture of sun. Then second picture you can see on your screen, it is the picture of star, right? So in this lesson we learn about things which we see in the sky during the day and at night. So there is the difference between the things and also different between the sky which you see during the day and which you see at the night, right? So in this lesson we learn many things, right? We learn about sunrise, sunset, moon, phases of moon, about stars and many other things. Then we learn about moon. So here you can see the picture of moon, right? So you can see that we can see sun in day when moon we can see in night, right? So here you can see the picture of sun, moon and star. We learn about different colors of the stars. Some are golden, some are silver, when some are in red color, right? Then we learn about the sunrise and sunset. So we learn about day and night, right? So this lesson is about the sun, moon and star. So first we revise this lesson, that what we learn about sun, moon and star in this lesson. Then we start writing the hard word. Right? So let's see what we learn in this lesson. So let's revise. We learn about sun, moon and star. So first when we start this lecture and we learn many things in science, right? So when we start this lesson, we learn about sky. Because in this lesson, we learn about the different things which we see in the sky, right? So we need to learn that where these all things are, right? So that's why first we learn about the sky, that we see many things in sky. Some are man-made, when some are natural things. So here you can see the picture of sky. Then first thing we learn that what can you see in the sky, right? So we see many things in the sky, but we learn about the natural things which we can see in the sky. So first here you can see the picture of sun. So when we start learning this lesson, so first thing we learn that we see sun in the sky, right? Then the second thing we learn is the moon. So we learn about moon because we can see moon in the sky in night. We cannot see moon mostly in the day, right? Sometimes you can see moon in the day also in sky, and here you can see that the picture of moon. So we learn about sun also, we learn about moon also. Then here next picture you can see is the picture of star. So we all know that stars are only visible at night. In this lesson we learn that stars and moon are also in sky during the day, but we cannot see them. Why? Because the sunlight is very bright, and because of that the stars and moon we cannot see. Right, so here you can see the picture of things which we learn in this lesson. So we learn about sky at different time. So first thing we learn in this lesson is sun, moon and star. So here you can see the picture of sun, moon and star. So we learn about sun, that what is sun, right? So sun is a big yellow ball of fire. We already learn about all these things. We just revise this. First question is that what is sun, right? So here you can see that what is sun. So here you can see the picture of sun. Now observe the sun. What is the color of the sun? Is that red? So here you can see the color of sun is yellow, right? So when we learn about sun, we learn that color of sun is yellow or orange, and it is looking like a big yellow ball of fire, right? So what is sun? The sun is looking like a big ball of fire. Now you think in your mind that what is fire, right? So let's see the sun. So here you can see the picture of sun, and what we learn? We learn that the sun is looking like a ball. So here you can see that the ball, and here you can see the sun, right? So the shape of the sun is round like a ball, right? So it is looking like a big ball, and it is the big ball of fire. So color of sun is yellow, and we all know that the color of fire is also yellow or red or orange, right? So looking like a big ball of fire. So here you can see, we just imagine, because the sun is a big yellow ball of fire, right? So here you can see if the ball of fire is looking like that. So maybe the sun is looking like that. As I told you that no one is taking picture of the sun, right? So here you can see the picture of big ball of fire, and it is the ball of fire. And what is this? It is sun, right? So now you can understand that in sunlight, when you are going, so your skin is become hot. When you touch the skin, it is warm, right? So why? Because the sunlight we get from the sun is we get from the fire of the sun. So first we learn about the sun, and sun is a big ball of fire. And when we see the sun during the day, right? So here you can see that what we learn about sun. Sun is a big star. It is hot. It is big ball of fire. It color in yellow or orange. So this all things we learn about sun, right? The big ball of fire, the big star, it is hot, and it is big ball of fire, color in yellow or orange. Then we learn about sunrise. So what is sunrise? In morning, sun rise from the west. No, sun is not rising from the west. Sun is rising from the east. So how the night, here you can see the picture of night, right? So how the sun rise? Let's see. So here you can see this slowly the sun rising. Sun is coming out, right? So as we learn in this lesson that sun is not going anywhere. Sun is on the place, but we are roaming around the sun. So here you can see the sunrise, and when the sunrise in morning, it bring us day. So in this lesson we learn about the sunrise, that sunrise bring us day. Here you can see the slowly sun is appear, right? So that's why we called it sunrise, and sunrise bring us day. And around noon at 12 o'clock you can see the bright sun in the sky. So sunrise bring us day, which we learn in this lesson, right? So then we learn about the sun. When we see the sun during the day, and it is shines very brightly whole day. We get heat and light from the sun. Sun shines bring us day, right? So this all things we learn in this lesson about sun, that why we need sun, because all living things, people, animals, plants need light and heat, and this thing we get from the sun, right? So today we revise about the sun, right? So here you can see that sun give us heat and light. So why we get light from sun? Because the sun is the main source of the light. During the day we don't need electricity because of sunlight, right? So here you can see the picture of sunlight which we get from the sun. In second picture you can see here the picture of plant, and you can see that plant grow because of the sunlight. So three things plant need to grow is water, air and sunlight, right? We already learn about this. Plants need sunlight to grow. Then we learn about water cycle. When we learn about water cycle, we all know that sunlight heated the water, and because of that the water vapor going up and make cloud, then we get rain, right? So all these things we learn in science about sun. Then the next thing we learn about sun is sunset bring us night. So in this lesson we learn about sunset. So what is sunset? So here you can see the picture of night. You cannot see sun in the sky. So what bring us night? The sun set bring us night. So slowly sun is disappear, and when the sun is totally disappear, it bring us night, right? So here you can see that the picture of sun is disappear, and because of that first we feel that it is evening. So here you can see the picture of evening, right? Here you can see the sun is going, and when the sun is disappear at that time the darkness in the sky, right? So we learn about this. We learn that we see the sun during the day, it shines brightly during the day, it gives heat and light, and all living things like plants, people and animals need light and heat. So here you can see the picture of sun rise, sunset, and sunset bring us day. So today we revise about sun, right? So now let's write the hard words. So as I told you, first we revise the lesson. So today we revise about sun, which we learn in this lesson. So let's write hard words in our team is hard words, right? So today we write the lesson number 14's hard words. And what is the name of this lesson? The name of this lesson is the sun, moon and star, right? So let's write the hard word of this lesson. So let's see first hard word. Our first hard word is the sun, right? So today we revise about sun. So when we read the name of this lesson, the name of this lesson is the sun, moon and star. So first word is the sun, right? So what is sun? Here you can see the picture of sun, a big yellow ball of fire, and the big yellow ball of fire is sun, right? So you can easily understand all these things. Why? Because we already learn all these things in this lesson, and today we revise also about sun. So what is the spelling of sun? S-U-N, sun, right? So here you can see the picture of sun. Then number 2, fire, F-I-R-E. So in this lesson what we learn about fire? Remember or not? When we learn about sun, we learn that sun is a big yellow ball of fire, right? So this is the fire. Here you can see the picture of fire. So I put here the ball of fire, right? So easily understand that we learn about sun, that sun is a big yellow ball of fire, right? So here you can see the picture of fire, right? Now let's see our third hard words. Heat, H-E-A-T. Now what is the meaning of heat? In this lesson we learn about sun, that sun give us heat and light, right? So now you tell me that what is heat, how we get heat from sun, and which thing give us heat? So when we learn about sun, we also learn about sunlight. So this sunlight give us heat. So here you can see the picture of one girl, and what is this? It is candy, right? And you can see the sun shines brightly, and because of sunlight the ice cream melt. So you can easily understand what is heat. Because of the heat of the sunlight, this ice cream melt. So what is the spelling of heat? H-E-A-T, heat, right? So you can understand the meaning of heat, right? Now let's see our next hard word. Our next hard word is light, L-I-G-H-T. Now you think in your mind that light, it means when you are going in room, first thing what you do, you on the light. So you think in your mind about lamp or about light, right? But in this lesson we learn about sunlight. Which light? Sunlight. So here So here you can see the picture of sun, and you can see the picture of sunlight also. And when the sun shines very brightly, so it gives us light. So what is the spelling of light? LIGHT. Because we learn in this lesson about sunlight, that why I put here the picture of sun and with the light. So we called it sunlight. The next one is sunrise. So what is the meaning of sunrise? Today we revise about sunrise also, right? So here you can see the picture of sunrise, and you can see the sun is rising. And when the sun rise, what bring us? It bring us morning. So that's why I put here good morning. So with this picture you can understand that the day will start because of sunrise. Sunrise bring us day, bring us morning. Then our next hard word is sunset. S-U-N-S-E-T. What is meaning of sunset? The sunset bring us day. Yes or no? No. Sunset bring us night. Sunrise bring us day, right? So here you can see the picture of sunset. It means sun disappear, and when the sun disappear, it bring us night, and everywhere there is darkness, right? So here you can see the picture of sunset. Then our next hard word is bring, B-R-I-N-G. So when we learn about sun in this lesson, we learn that sunset bring us night, sunrise bring us day. So here you can see the picture of sunset and sunrise also, right? So because of sunrise bring us day, sunset bring us night, right? So bring means give us, right? So here you can see the picture of sunset and sunrise. East, E-A-S-T. East means there are four directions, right? Which are the east, west, north and south. So in this lesson we learn about two directions, and which are the east and west. And how we learn? That sun rise from the east. So it is the one direction. So here you can see the sunrise, and you can see the picture of east. So from where the sun rise, the sun rise from the east, right? So you can understand what is the meaning of east. It is the one direction, right? Now let's see our next direction is west, W-E-S-T. So sunrise from the east when the sun set in the west. So what is the meaning of west? It is the again one direction, right? So W-E-S-T, west, sun set in the west, right? Now let's see our next hard word. Our next hard word is moon, M-O-O-N, moon. So what is meaning of moon? Let's see the picture. Here you can see the picture, moon. And what is moon? Big white ball, right? So here you can easily understand what is moon. You all see moon at sky in night, right? So it is easy for you. Then our next hard word is night, N-I-G-H-T. So in this lesson we learn about day and night, and we learn about sky, which we see in day and it is different from night. So here you can see the picture of night. So night, there is no sun, that's why the night is dark, the sky is dark. So here you can see the picture of stars, right? So in night at sky we can see the stars in the sky. Observe, O-B-S-E-R-V-E. It means looking carefully, right? So here you can see the picture of student who are looking sky very carefully. It is just a picture, right? So you can see here the moon also, and you can see here the stars also. So we have to observe the sky at night also, in day also. Shape. So what is the meaning of shape? S-H-A-P-E. We learn about different shape. You also learn about different shape, right? In maths, right? So here we learn about the different shape of the moon. The shape of the moon changes every day. We learn in this lesson the shape of the moon changes every day. So what is the spelling of shape? S-H-A-P-E, shape, right? So half moon, quarter moon, full moon, right? So all these things we learn in this lesson. Then phases of the moon. So the moon shape is changes every day, right? So what we called it? We called it phases of the moon, right? So here you can see the phases of the moon, because the moon is different every night. And sometime one day in a month there is no moon in the sky, right? So you can understand the different shape of the moon known as phases of the moon, right? Now let's see our next hard word. Our next hard word is stars. You all see stars in the night, right? So here you can see the picture of stars. It is tiny and it is also shines, right? So when we learn about star, we all learn about star that star is very big bulb, because they all are so far away from us, that's why they look tiny. So here you can see the picture of moon and you can see the picture of star. Now the stars are looking small when the moon is looking big. So tiny means looking small, right? So here you can see that stars are looking tiny, right? It is very small, right? So you can easily understand that tiny means very small when the moon is big. So I circle the tiny stars. And the next third word is far away, F-A-R-A-W-A-Y, right? So what is the meaning of far away? So here you can see the picture of one house and you can see stars are very far away. So it means the thing which is on distance, we called it far away, right? So here in this lesson we learn about stars, that stars are far away from us, right? So that's why I put here the picture of the star and one house. Then patterns. So what is meaning of patterns? Patterns means designs, right? So when we start writing, right, in starting in when you are in nursery, so when you write the A, so what you do? You join the dots and making A. So it is the design, right? So like that in this lesson we learn about patterns. But which patterns? We learn about patterns which formed by the stars in the sky. When you see sky carefully, you can understand this pattern. So I circle the patterns, because the different type of patterns you can see in the sky at night, and this pattern formed by the stars, right? So here you can see the picture of different patterns, right? So this is formed by the stars. And the great bear is one of the pattern which you can see in the sky. Here you can see this the pattern of the star, and you can see this pattern is known as great bear, right? So there are many different patterns in the sky, right? So you can easily understand this hard word, because it is the name of the one pattern which you can see in the sky. It is the pattern of seven stars. When you count the star, you can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. This pattern is also known as seven stars pattern, right? So this we learn in this lesson. So what we done today? Today we complete the hard word. First we revise the sun, then we write the hard word. So I hope you all enjoy what we learn in this lecture, and I hope you understand what we learn. So take care of yourself and stay healthy.